know Nevik was coming?
What are you talking about? Nevik?
Yeah, like troops, paramilitary mercenaries. There's a military cruiser docked to the base. There's men with guns everywhere. Major bad vibes. I can't even tell you.
Where's Braddock?
He's behind closed doors with the guy who seems to be in charge. Don't even get me started on him. I think I heard him asking about you. I didn't know whether to tell you to come in or warn you to stay away.
Well, I'm already here.
We're going around in circles. I'm here now. We're investigating, and we'll reassess the situation once all the facts are in hand. Ah, Peyton, is it? Thank you for coming. Mr. Braddock, if we could have the room.
Pardon me, but this is his office.
Jim, don't. Don't make waves. Not now.
Looks like you got everyone good and freaked out. That's why you're here?
I can see why you're so well respected around here. A natural leader. I am here, you could say, to provide perspective.
You mean Nevik's perspective?
Well, considering the resources we've expended to make this effort possible, one could say that that is the perspective.
I don't work for Nevik.
Indeed. But you take the credits Nevik pays you, so perhaps I can prevail upon you to hear me out. I'm sure that you'll come to realize I'm not here to dismantle Braddock's operation, but to make sure that it counts for something. Why are you here? Your family, correct? I understand that motivation better than you think. So, tell me, Peyton, is there some other priority? Some new agenda that you place ahead of your family's safety? Something more important to you now than ever seeing them again? Of course not. Let me tell you why I'm here. I'm here for the human race. Not just for my son's future, but for all the children of Earth to escape extinction. And there is nothing and no one that I will allow to get in my way. That's all. DeGreen, have we located that Dr. Roman yet?
Hey, those Nevik goons just dropped off a box of parts for your rig. Something about charging a drained battery, like those big Zeus numbers on the fueling depots. Alright, I think we go claw them with this one. Wire up the fingers, make them into jumper clamps. Yeah, that could work.
Thank you.
And then I cranked it to the nines with some Primo booster packs. I lifted off some old T-190s. Pack wrap power for the win, right? So check it. Your claw arm is juiced. Pump it and you can charge batteries in a flash. Got a feeling it would charbroil an acrid in a few seconds too. But you let me know, okay?
Above and beyond as always, kid.
Oh, and I'm calling it the Shock Jumper. Now get out there and shock jump some things. I want LaRoche begging for one, so I can tell him to stuff it. Sweet! Let's do this thing! Really cramps my style with those mercs everywhere. Always a pleasure, my man.
Hey, what's the rumpus, Jim?
Gail got you rummaging around for scrap, huh?
Good deal, good deal. You be careful out there, kiddo.
hard.
Breakthrough on the source of the storms. Come see me at your earliest.